Morning. This is a photo I've worked from before several times. It's Brittany, Carnac. It could be anywhere. It's a fisherman's cottages, holiday cottages, homes by the sea. And what I've done is to do some sort of design here to make up a painting on the other side. So we'll put a simple cottage, or maybe two, simple Brittany cottage. I'm using reference material. The view that I'm going to make up doesn't really exist, but it's just an exercise in improvising, making up a scene from what you've got. We'll put a few rocks into the bottom here if we can, and I'm going to use my stipple to put in the tree. But before I do, I think I should quickly put in some sort of cottage here. So for that, I'm just going to use a bit of white just to show a bit of that. Would be quite good there. We'll have the sort of roof coming down there. Be sure your sides of the roof and that roof there are parallel. Something like that. Just to remind me where it's going to go. We can put another. Shall we? No, let's just keep it simple. So there's the sea going across there. Bit of the beach. So that will do. Now the cottage is sort of all full on the back, so that will be slightly down there like that. Should we put the other side? That'll do. Just a focal point or point of interest, the main point of interest, so everything will point to that. So I'm going to start stippling now. I'm going to use my usual lemon yellow, bit of black, bit of sienna, burnt sienna, and just make a surface of dots. This helps a bit of dragging and after. Once you've got all these pimples or surface, you can drag over it to your heart's content. So we'll go over the cottage a bit. Plenty of air. I usually paint the sky first and superimpose everything on top of that. But I think it's also a good idea to paint down to the landscape, because that way you seem to get a better impact rather than superimposing. It seems more solid line. It just has a greater impact for some reason that I can't remember. Whatever I do here is going to be painted over. So we've got some nice lights up there. I'll bring the sky into that, of course. But it's just a bit of coast, so we want some more blue, bluey green as we go distant, so we'll just put that in there. Okay, that'll do for a start. Now let's put in some rocks. Now the rocks in the bit of work that I'm working from. Now this part of Brittany, you can get a lot of voices on these rocks. So we had a bit of yellow ochre. The rocks seem to be vertical there. I might even go over this with a knife. want that quite warm, so that oak was I don't know if a knife would help in this situation when I find the knives. Got a pot full of knives here and a spare hake waiting to be broken in when I get back to some knife painting, some watercolours. So let's just... This is all going to be painted over. This is just a... quite dark here. Just a support for the rest of the painting here. Well, don't let too lumpy there because it'd be difficult to paint over, so we'll have a bit of greys. Right, that's okay for the moment. We'll let that dry and go back and do a bit of sky now. By which time I hope that the foliage will be quite dry. Have a look at the work of the techniques of Terry Harrison. It's online, especially his watercolours where he uses sponges and acrylic over the watercolour. Well, he does a watercolour sky, then he does all this stippling with bits of sponge. Very, very exciting. Now, what sort of sky should we have? Shall we have a little bit of dark? So let's try a burnt umber. It's a great oil paint with ultramarine, so we'll try a mix with some white. We'll see what happens. Nice thundery sort of angry sort of sky. I might not like this when I see it on. So. I'll use a bit of blue or varnish. Bit of anger. I tinted the board with burnt sienna mostly, and I put in some black where behind the green. Right, okay, that's a so the usual light red, white and a bit of yellow ochre. And I want this light round the trees. Now that's too even now, I'm going to have to go back over there. I know it looks an absolute mess at the moment. Just want a bit of black in to see if that improves it. Scroll over Karnak or Morbihan Basin. Morbihan Bay. Southern Brittany. Oh, I just drag over that.
Okay. Having fun.
Clean the brushes. Lost a brush in the main. Let's do a lightish bluey, ochrey sea. Let's get this just sea level. Oops, I'm still wet. A little bit darker than that horizon. Right, back to the stipple. Just keep working over it till you get a bit of a pleasant surprise. So catching some light on the edges of this tree here, and we'll have a bit of warm. The easiest way I know to do foliage on boards, it works, but when you get your darks and lights, I need to bring that horizon up a bit. Just ease it in. Don't want it too consistent. We'll have reflections coming down here. A bit of burnt umber and a little bit of sand. Coming down a bit there. just easing in the beach here. And we'll put in some rocks over the other side there. Use a bit of black and a bit of burnt sienna. Right, let that go for a minute. Go back to the sky now. Is drying nicely. Gonna lighten it all up now. It's very, 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 very dark and brooding, so we'll just building up this texture so that I can drag. So I want that to cloud there. Just take out some of the dark in that cloud. I'm finding that black mixed with the ultramarine and white make a very good cloud. Coming on. Now we'll get some really angry. We did see some angry weather when we were there. We've been there three times. Lovely, lovely beaches, just lovely. Just going into the distance there. Where's my beach colour? It's still wet there. Alright, let's go back to the grey. Black, blue, a little white. Just taking some of the bittiness out of the sky now, because it's only an underpainting. Get some nice light with the fan going. Okay. Lighten up here. Just a nice bit of sunlight coming from underneath those heavy clouds as the squall clears. This is where I want it fairly light, around the trees. Oh, I've got some more light even than that. That's showing up nice and interesting. Right, now go back with the greens. Just dragging over now, over the high spots. Blue, red, black. Nice and dark in there. So I'm looking for dark spots against which to counter change the lights. This is the shadow areas in here. Nice shadow. Don't be frightened of blacks. Okay, and we'll have some bit of orange just to warm up some of these darker areas, and also using a bit of light red into the mix. You can bounce some of your greens, your bright greens against. That's just some distance coming in there. Bit of recession. I've needed some more darks now. But I want red in the dark, so I need to put in some of my nice light red tube. I'll let that go. I'm going to put in that sea colour now. That's a nice sort of lightish blue, but darker than what I've got there. And if you mix a little bit of yellow ochre in with it, it gives it a more realistic colour. It's more a sea green rather than a blue green. Now just now for that to show, I really need to go lighter on that horizon. Just soften it. Bring your sea into the sky and the sky into the sea. I'm getting sky colours into the sea here. Just dragging gently. Just leaving some of that background colour, the ground, to show through. And then got the light here, so let's just gently drag over where that light is coming from these clouds. Okay. Really, just bring that up there a little bit. Right, okay, I'll go back to the ochre colour, sandy colour, mix a bit of umber, because umber mixed with a bit of umber mixed with a bit of yellow ochre and a bit of white. It's a good. Those rocks didn't work outside plants. I might put those in with a knife. Let's put in the house now. So we'll have this slightly in the shadow. This is where we've got the really nice white. We'll have a blacky bluey roof, a slight roof catching the light. Chimney's part, I'm putting the shadow side, catching the light. Okay. Right, let's put in some rocks. Might be better to do that with a knife. Let's have a little. A bit of a grey rock colour there. Where? Oh, let's go back over there. Right, let's get in some greeny coming down there. It's got to show though. Find some darker green showing reflections. Just putting in the tiles and edges off. No, that's daft, isn't it? It's under the chimney stack. I'll paint that out, that's dry. Thank you. Right, let's put in some little bits and pieces on that shoreline, just a bit of... Just some interest. And we'll that's all we need to do there. So we stuck up against there. Now we'll put in a couple of or one. Well, I think we'll do white sail against this. It should show up. Put in a bit of under there. Nearly done. We've got to do some work down here though. My little brush. There it is. Let's try and get your reflection straight. Well, I've got to go a bit more in there, but I want that edge of those little tiny ripples to stand up. I don't want to go over those. I just want to do these rocks now. No, I'd rather do that with a knife. That's a good image with some nice rocky colours. I was trying to show the strata in these rocks. In the shadow of the rocks. Warm greys here coming up. Well, they're not very realistic, are they? But well, I don't know, they're not too bad. Right, with my finer bristle brush here, let's get some white on there. I really want to do a bit more on those trees here. It's nice and dry. I'll sign it while I've got the brush in my hand. Back. Just about shows. Because what I've got on here is quite a nice rough surface now. I can just drag. I might even put a bit more light in the sky. It's a bit of a dull picture, but it's after a squall. That's my take on things. And we'll just get some lemon yellow, a bit of white. I'll adjust. I won't put any detail on like branches, I don't think. Thank you. So just picking up the high spots there. Look. Okay. Oh, a flash of light now. I might red a bit of ochre. Right, that will do. I'll put it in a frame. Just about dry around the edges. Well, there it is. I suppose, do you think we could put a figure in? No, it's not bother. Right, okay. Let's come down. I hope you saw all that. There's my cottage. Light catching the roof and the side of the buildings with windows. No detail, just a, you saw me do those. Some little bits of interest here and there. Rocks, sort of. And a clearing sky after the storm. After the storm, we'll say. And I suppose. No, I won't even say what I was going to say. I hope you enjoyed that. Let's just show you around the stippled bit. Here you go. I've got lots of colour in there. Just dragged over those stipples that I put in. The stipple isn't just so much painting leaves as putting a colour on, but leaving all these thousands of pimples to create this lovely surface. I'm painting on hardboard, as you know. So there we are. So we'll have a quick look at the rocks. I struggled with those, so we won't dwell on them. Alright, let's just come out and come down there. Alright, there we are. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.